the GVol's educational YouTube series. Today we're going to talk about option skew and why this makes sense. Two of the assumptions in the Black-Scholes model are one, that the underlying volatility or the volatility of the underlying asset is going to be constant throughout the life of the option, and two, continuously compounded returns are normally distributed. Now in practice, these assumptions don't hold up. Volatility is not constant throughout the life of the option, and continuously compounded returns of most assets are not normally distributed. So how do we deal with this? Now, here's how option skew comes into play. Something that you'll notice is that options within a given expiration will have different implied volatilities at different strike prices. This is option skew. When you're using the Black-Scholes formula, those two assumptions that we described earlier fail. And in order to compensate for that, traders will price different options or different strike prices of options with different implied volatilities. Theoretically, if you had the perfect pricing formula for options, you could see implied volatilities that are equal across all the various strikes. But with Black-Scholes, that is not the case. Typically, options on stock indexes display a lot of skew. You'll notice that puts are very expensive compared to equidistant calls. Now, there's two reasons for this. The first reason is the panic effect. When prices crash, they tend to crash by a larger magnitude in percentage terms than when prices rally. On a typical rally day, you'll see prices rally about 0.5% or 1% or maybe 2%. But on sell-off days, you'll see moves of 3%, 5%, even in some rare instances, up to 20% losses in one day. That differential between the magnitude of upside moves versus downside moves is part of the reason for skew. The second reason why stock index options display a large skew is because of correlation. When everyone is selling, correlation tends to go to one. And you can think of it from a fundamental perspective too. When there's a systematic shock to the economy, all companies tend to lose value together. But when the economy is humming along, some companies are doing well and some companies are doing poorly. So what does this mean? This means that the diversification effects of owning a stock index are greatly reduced in a bearish environment than when you're in a bullish environment. So when you're in a bearish environment, your index tends to mimic a single stock equity. But when you're in a bullish environment, you have a diversified index. When you combine these two effects together, we can see why traders will require a premium for selling puts versus selling calls. Because when the market hits bearish territory, the magnitude of the moves to the downside are going to be greater than the magnitude of the moves to the upside. And not only that, the correlation going to one makes the index lose its diversification value. So therefore, the index itself becomes more risky. That differential between what put implied volatility trades at and what call implied volatility trades at is the skew. Rarely will you see implied volatilities constant across various strike prices. Typically, all assets have some sort of option volatility skew. Thanks so much for watching our video. And remember, find edge, capture alpha, and slang size.